In Denmark, there stands an old castle named Kronenburg, close by the Sound of Elsinore, where large ships, both English, Russian, and Prussian, pass by hundreds every day. And they salute the old castle with cannons. Boom! Boom! Which is as if they said, good day! And the cannons of the old castle answer, boom! Which means, many thanks! In winter, no ships sail by, for the whole sound is covered with ice as far as the Swedish coast, and has quite the appearance of a high road. The Danish and Swedish flags wave, and Danes and Swedes say good day and thank you to each other, not with cannons, but with a friendly shake of the hand, and they exchange white bread and biscuits with each other, because foreign articles taste the best. But the most beautiful sight of all is the old castle of Kronenburg, where Holger Dansk sits in the deep, dark cellar into which no one goes. He is clad in iron and steel, and rests his head on his strong arm. His long beard hangs down upon the marble table, into which it has become firmly rooted. He sleeps and dreams, but in his dreams he sees everything that happens in Denmark. On each Christmas Eve, an angel comes to him and tells him that all he has dreamed is true, and that he may go to sleep again in peace, as Denmark is not yet in any real danger. But should danger ever come, then Holger Dansk will rouse himself, and the table will burst asunder as he draws out his beard. Then he will come forth in his strength and strike a blow that shall sound in all the countries of the world. An old grandfather sat and told his little grandson all this about Holger Dansk, and the boy knew that what his grandfather told him must be true. As the old man related this story, he was carving an image in wood to represent Holger Dansk, to be fastened to the prow of a ship, for the old grandfather was a carver in wood, that is, one who carved figures for the heads of ships, according to the names given to them. And now he had carved Holger Dansk, who stood there, erect and proud, with his long beard, holding in one hand his broad battle-axe, while with the other he leaned on the Danish arms. The old grandfather told the little boy a great deal about Danish men and women who had distinguished themselves in olden times, so that he fancied he knew as much even as Holger Dansk himself, who after all could only dream, and when the little fellow went to bed, he thought so much about it that he actually pressed his chin against the counterpane, and imagined that he had a long beard which had become rooted to it,